Welcome back to The Wandering Screen. I'm Matt Koss, and today I'm looking at Justin Baldoni's adaptation of Colleen Hoover's It Ends With Us. Would you believe that Colleen Hoover's It Ends With Us got me back into reading? I had spent years reading scripts, and since the COVID pivot, found myself with time to open books again. And while it's a difficult story, it was also a really easy read, and I flew through it before I went in the opposite direction and started Dune. The Justin Baldoni film is very faithful to the book. It has the same schmaltzy atmosphere of a melodrama, but with an absorbing direction set in Boston as the leaves are changing color. The whole film feels like an autumn-winter cusp coziness in spite of its plot. Now, age doesn't matter, obviously, but an important distinction between the book and the film is that in the book, our protagonist Lily Bloom is 23 years old. In the film, Blake Lively does not exactly read as 23. In fact, her age is never mentioned. So please, as you're watching this video, let's keep a list of things we don't know about Lily Bloom. Lily visits her hometown in Maine after her dad dies. There's hints at a difficult relationship with her father, and when she gets to Boston, she sits on a random high-rise rooftop in the city where she meets Ryle Kincaid, Justin Baldoni. Why is Lily sitting on the rooftop of a building she doesn't live in, and who could have possibly seen that space 20 floors up as a comfortable hangout spot from street level? Added to the list of things we don't know about Lily Bloom. Anyway, Ryle is a neurosurgeon who just had to come upstairs and kick a chair over, and he ends up connecting with a surprised but intrigued Lily. He leaves abruptly for an emergency and months later meets Lily again at her newly opened flower shop, Lily Blooms, where his sister Alyssa, played by Jenny Slate, now works. As their relationship develops and they frequent the scene in Boston, they double date with Ryle's sister and her husband, Marshall Hassan Minaj, at a restaurant owned by Atlas Corrigan, Brandon Sklenar, who is dreamy, calm, slightly disheveled, and successful. He could rival any neurosurgeon. As the past creeps into Lily's present, we're escorted into flashbacks to learn how Lily and Atlas connected and fell out of touch in their teenage years as Lily looks the other way to Ryle's rising abuse. Who is Lily Bloom? Does she have any friends in Boston or her hometown? Does she live in an apartment? Do we know if the electricity is working? She knows how to drive a car, but does she live in it? What exactly has she been doing since her father almost killed Atlas when they were teenagers? We're missing, I don't know, let's pretend Lily is 30. So 12 years we're missing. What income was she earning? How did she afford this flower shop? Who are her suppliers? It's questions I had both with the book and now with the film. And while it doesn't take away from the film itself, I missed that connection to a character, something relational and humanistic. Where was she getting these baggy modern outfits from? Flashbacks are supposed to be our navigation into Lily's history, but we meet her at a specific point in her life. And a particularly impactful one, particularly following her father's death. She is entering into a relationship that will mimic her mother's with her father. The script does allow for breathing room for the actors to interpret and add their characterization. I warmed to Blake Lively's performance by the midway point and thought Baldoni was effective as someone who could be sympathetic, but then you see the horrible, abusive, and emotionally manipulative side. Jenny Slate is also wonderful here as Ryle's sister, Alyssa, providing the film a much-needed light-heartedness and eagerness. Then there's Brandon Sklenar. Have you seen 1923? It's on Paramount Plus. It stars Helen Mirren and Harrison Ford, but the only character that I remember was Sklenar's Ranger, who steals the series. He's as equally charismatic in this film. The intensity of Baldoni's performance is brilliantly matched with Sklenar's laid-back chef, who will watch curiously from the sidelines, patiently waiting for the time Lily will be ready to be with him. It's also because Baldoni really intensifies the aggression of Lily's father and Ryle into sharp, fragmented cuts of abuse. So you're feeling the atmosphere of pain rather than seeing it completely on screen. So I feel like Ryle's aura changes as we see that aggressive side take over, which makes Atlas so damn appealing. Also, the film is gorgeous. Production designers Russell Barnes and Annie Simeon, along with the set decorators, imagine one of the most beautiful florist stores I've never been to. You can tell that there's a lot of love that went into the project, no matter the supposed drama behind the scenes. Less successful is the on-the-nose soundtrack. Just watch as Lily and Ryle start hooking up for the first time, and Cigarettes After Sex's Nothing's Gonna Hurt You Baby starts playing. Like, we know someone is going to hurt her, and it's going to be Vile Ryle. A scored piece might have worked better in those tender moments instead of relying on pop songs like Taylor Swift's My Tears Ricochet when Lily is walking down the street down in the dumps. Also, Tom York's Dawn Chorus also becomes a running motif in the first half of the film, and as much as I rallied against its use, it's actually translated gorgeously here. It Ends With Us has done great at the box office, and it's going to do even better streaming. Supposed behind-the-scenes drama aside, the film is worth the watch with a cup of hot chocolate and Baileys, if only to find out for yourself, who is Lily Bloom? What if she's an apparition?
Lily Bloom.
Atlas. You look so well. I don't want to get you in trouble or anything.
Hey, well,
so.
How do I find you? If I wanted to find you.
I opened my flower shop, Lily Blooms.
Of course you did.
Yeah, over in Back Bay. So, you know, you can look me up sometime. Or...
Well, I gotta, you know.
Yeah.
I'm working, so.
Okay, get out of here.
I'm gonna go. All right.
Okay.
Thank you for watching. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for all the latest film and TV discussions. And let me know what you thought of the film below in the comments section. See you next time.